Hi guys, this is User1 and welcome to another episode of LSRP. Today I'm gonna do, I think it looks kinda cool. I'm gonna show you how to put a thing in the trunk, right? So you need to open the trunk, even on the van, right? And you need to place blah blah blah, and then you drag it all the way over there and have police, like, be concerned about you, right? And then you drag it off. So this is how you put a dash cam on your car, right? Just do that. If that makes sense. Probably doesn't. I'm horrible at explaining things. Anyway, yeah, we're just gonna play a little bit. Thank you guys who participated in my live stream yesterday. It was really good. I was really happy to see even, like, the 20 people that did join. I mean, it's... Usually I get, like, 1,000 views, but the 1,000 views come over the course of, like, 24 hours. Which is, you know, a long time. When I see a bunch of people show up for my couple of hours live stream, that's already cool, because I can imagine, like, this amount of people in a room, and it, you know, it's a lot of people. It's not like nothing. Right. Take gun, because we got permission to carry now. We got permission to carry safely. Now what do we want to do? We want to offer our services as bodyguards. Looks like there's some sort of altercation. What are these guys doing? They're on the rooftop. They're gonna kill themselves. By the way, I reinstalled this Nikos ENV in hopes of getting my mods back. It didn't work, but I got the ENV, so here's how it looks like. Plop. And super lag. Super lag. I can also modify it. Well, I can't without... Well, I mean, I'm breaking, this Nikos terms of service by modifying it, but, you know, I can't physically do it. Anyway, I'm not gonna use it, because it's, like, really tanking my FPS, and... When I was buying some weapons earlier, of course some people already knew that I had gun license, so they immediately rushed me, they ran me over, and I just had no chance, because the lag was real. The lag was just... I couldn't even aim at them, that's how bad it was. Like, the one time I did get aim at them, I did hit them, but, like, there was no chance, because, like, I didn't even expect them to move. They basically teleported into me, and they didn't roleplay ramming me anyway, so, I don't know, maybe I'll report them for that. Anyway, here we are, we're gonna be driving to the mall to make an advert. Really weird, I had a feminist encounter on the mall, and I think I wanted to make a video about it, but then I considered, it's a controversial topic, and controversial topics will always get downvoted. But yeah, basically feminism exists in LSRP culture. Anyway, I won't be talking about it, because if the woman who was accusing Jeffrey of crimes he didn't commit wasn't lying out of character and then quit doing roleplay, I wouldn't be talking about it. Because, you know, when I encounter people who are racist, misogynist, whatever the fuck, I don't care. I don't care, because it's roleplay server, it's in character. It's in character, that's a character you're roleplaying, okay? Ivan Khrushchev is fucking sexist as fuck, okay? Look, here's a video of him getting a blowjob. okay, I'm gonna get discharged. Anyway, so now... So what I've been talking about is, if you read my guide on you are not your character, this means basically that you should separate yourself from your character, okay? This is just basically what I mean, you know? By that, I mean that... Basically, to roleplay someone, you gotta remember that, like, to roleplay properly, you gotta separate yourself from your character. Because if you always consider your character to be yourself, and always consider your character to be you, you will always power game. You will power game unintentionally. And then you look back at the situation and you'll go, huh, I really power game there. I won't be able to dodge the fucking knife, I won't be able to dodge the fucking bullet, I'm not Neo. Yeah, you know? But in real life, when you're thinking about, you know, extreme situations that you often encounter in LSRP, you always think, ooh, I'll be able to dodge, I'll be able to jump 10 feet, you know, stuff like that, bullshit, that's not really true. But you think about it because your brain is very confident in your abilities, overconfident, because you're a teenager. Chances are, you are a teenager, maybe a little bit over teenager, maybe you're in your 20s, 30s, either way, unless you're, like, elderly, you will not be considering yourself disabled to any extent, right? You will not be considering yourself that much. You will, if you think of yourself in emergency situations, you will be thinking, oh, I'm a fucking Neo, I'll be able to do everything. That's not true, though. Because most of us don't really encounter in shootout situations. I wasn't ever in a shootout. I bet 99.9999% of you were never in a shootout. I doubt any of you were in a shootout. If you ever won a shootout, comment down below. I would love to hear your story. Anyway, we're gonna offer personal bodyguard for hire services. I need to wait 41 seconds. Like, I already talked about this like a million times, but for one, why do you have to make an ad? Like, this is a green zone, you're not supposed to commit crimes, and he's committing a crime, he's harassing me right now. But obviously he's doing it for attention. Anyway, right, just ignore these people. Like, if you're actually... Like, if you're actually trying to roleplay someone, if you're actually trying to roleplay a disability, you wouldn't be running around jumping, you would be doing it to everyone, you wouldn't be discriminating only the people who are filming it, likely, okay? And I most often cut this out. The reason why you don't get daily videos that, like, this, the reason why you didn't get daily video yesterday or the day, the 2 days before that, is because I cut people out. I cut people out like this. I'm not gonna cut him out this time, but I cut people out 99% of the time. I ignore them on purpose because obviously they're all they're trying to do is get. You don't walk up to strangers and say, "Hey, let's take a selfie," okay? It's not a thing that happens. Maybe in like a special setting, maybe like if you're classmates or maybe if you're co-workers, maybe. Even if you don't know their names, maybe if you're co-workers, that's fine. But if you're walking up to a random stranger... If you're walking up to a random stranger and doing shit, like, okay, he said it's a prank. Who is filming it? No one is filming it. So what's the point of the prank if no one's filming it? I mean, I understand that there's a trend going on of pranks that are not really pranks, that are just harassing people. That's fine! But have someone film it then! Just don't fucking... And roleplay it properly. Don't be an asshole, man. Also, okay, back to advertisement place. This is not a place to make an advertisement. You don't stand in the middle of a mall and suddenly an advertisement appears. That's not how it works, okay? You go to an office. There are offices. There are offices around the place. Hold on, I'll try to make an ad and I'll show you that there are, in fact, offices. Because there are offices. There are offices... Well, that used to be an office down there. That's now Dealer Sars. Wait, what did it say? DDR Sars? Oh my god. Another issue is that you have to spam, basically. I got it this time, so I can just walk away. Okay, see, this guy is angry because he didn't get the ad. Fuck, I didn't get the ad. Okay, look at here. Look at here. Okay, this is not an office. This is like a bar area. But it used to be an office. Make another office area. I don't know, make you come over here at least for an ad. But then you'd have like a line in front of it and that doesn't make sense. If you had like an office area like you did before you turned it into that bullshit place, then it would make more sense. This used to be an office area. Why did they change it to a fucking luxury shop? No one ever comes here now. No one ever comes. I used to come here to roleplay paying PF licenses, all that bullshit. I used to come here to roleplay doing like ads and stuff. But now there's nothing like that. You should create like an office area where you go to make an ad, okay? And you also should... And instead of having people spam ads, you should have them fucking be able to actually, like, how do I say it? You should have them be able to make ad to a queue, like, you know what I mean? Like, okay, say you walk up to an office area, which there isn't one, but let's pretend this is, okay, perfect, this is the perfect office area, look at this. You come here to buy an advert sign. There's a bar here, but whatever, okay? So let's say this is an office, bro, okay? Because you already buy a sign here. So let's say you walk up to, I don't know, an agent over here. It doesn't have to be NPC, just... Okay, could be an internet cafe. This looks like an internet cafe, okay? So let's say this is an internet cafe where you make ads, okay? So you walk up to a computer, or maybe you just need to be in the room, and you just type ad, blah, 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 right? What happens is, instead of this ad just checking if there has been 60 seconds since the last ad, it adds your ad to a queue, you know? A queue of ads, like a line, you know? So say someone first advertised, okay, last ad, okay. So say all these three people come at the same time to make an advert. So this guy advertised first, but a few seconds later, this guy advertised. So what happens is, no, it doesn't give you a message, "Ooh, you can't advertise for the next 57 seconds. Instead, it just puts the ad in line, and after 57 seconds, it advertises that. If within these 57 seconds, this guy comes in, which is me, then he gets like put on advertisement in another minute. That sounds really simple for me. Why don't you just make that? Maybe you'll have like huge lines of ads then, and you will be just not able to make ad then. But it's better than having to spam. It's better than having to spam. Or also make it so that if the advertiser leaves the game, all his ads will not advertise. Nah. I don't know, man. I don't know. Maybe they tried it before and didn't work. I shouldn't judge people. Alright, let's keep going. Because it doesn't make any fucking sense to have advertisement just in the middle of the mall. Have it in the office at least, okay? Have at least people spamming it in the office if you're gonna have people spamming it, okay? Alright, it doesn't look like anyone's calling us. Whatever, let's go. Whatever. I had a voice crack there. Alright, so... Alright, we're gonna drive back. We're gonna have something to eat. I think we need... Oh, by the way, I noticed that the pizza stack doesn't have anything to feed people, so I think I'm gonna go. I think this is an opportunity to make some money by delivering food to pizza stack. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna drive that with our little van. A bunch of people keep asking me, "Hey, what's the best way to make money? What's the best way to make money?" If there was the best way to make money, everyone would do it. Everyone would fucking do it. My best way to make money is to roleplay. Okay, best way. If you really want to make money, just make a stripper character and roleplay being a stripper. Like, properly roleplay being a stripper, a bunch of rich people will tip you, and then name change to someone else, right? That's how you make money best. Just, yeah. But if you... The one thing you gotta realize is that it's not gonna give you anything fun to do. Money alone does not give any fun to you. Trust me, I have collected my savings at $20 million, and I know that money does not give you fun alone. To have fun with money, you gotta do something. You gotta be creative. If you don't have any money and you don't wanna be a stripper, just how about you, I don't know, do something creative. Get a friend, do something creative with them. Like me and Callan, we roleplayed father and daughter. That was some fun shit. You can't deny that. That was really, a really liked video. Anyway, we're gonna get this friend, we're gonna make some money. So yeah, you can also be a trucker, and I love the trucker system in this game. I just love it. Honestly, I just love this trucker system. So let's take a look at the trucker PDA. Oh, something's happening over there. He's getting arrested. These guys are getting arrested. Looks like a shots fired situation. Or just a fight. Could be just a fight. There's a lot of bullshit going down. Jesus, why do these black people just keep dying? Anyway. Alright, let's truck PDA. Show businesses accepting cargo. Meal, what is this? Blood knuckles boxing, no. Remove CP. Truck PDA. Meal. Sudden stop. What is this? Vinewood. Oh, it's accepting at 400. That's good actually. Okay, let's go. So we're gonna go to the food processing plant, which is where you get a meal, but we're gonna make a stop on the way to collect a little bit of Now keep in mind, I have a millionaire character just sitting off, but I'm doing this just for fun. Now, to be honest, I didn't do this to make money, because I collected my savings before I was ever a trucker. So I did this like kind of for fun, and I want to see if someone tries to rob me. That would be really fun. Anyway, alright, let's see how long this will take. Let's time this out. Because this will take a while. This is like... This is if you're fun... Oh, by the way, I wanted to tell people how to drive properly. So if you don't know, the DMV is bullshit. You're supposed to stop at the white line and look left and right before you proceed, okay? This is how you're supposed to do it. Stop, look left. You don't need to look right if you're turning right, because you're not going on that lane. But yeah, you can just do it if, in case someone is driving on the wrong lane, like usual. But yeah. Also, I'm driving towards the highway the legitimate way. Now, What really pisses me off is the cops. They don't take the legitimate way. They drive off-road, they drive on oncoming traffic. It doesn't matter to them. It really pisses me off a little bit. Because I always try to take the legitimate route. Right, let's go. Right, so if you're trying to merge into a lane, first, you need to, in real life, you need to look at in your rearview mirror, in like the mirror on to the side before you turn, right? To make sure that it's clear. So what I'm trying to do here is, I'm pressing Q and E at the same time. If I press Q first and E, it'll make my character look to the left as if he's looking at the mirror anyway. And I can see behind me, if there's anyone behind me. Let me remove the stupid text that no one is using anyway. So I can, after I seen that, I can merge and I'm not gonna lag pit anyone. So if someone's driving there, you don't wanna pit them. Because knowing how to lag pit people is good, because you're gonna know how to not lag pit people as well. Anyway, we'll keep driving here. It's nothing interesting. I'm just gonna shut up now. Coming out to a toll booth, I love how people just open toll, but I guess it doesn't, it's not a big deal, but I like to sometimes roll windows down, hold on, front left that is, and just open all that. I don't usually like do in-depth slash me slash do all that bullshit when I'm alone, but that doesn't mean I'm not role-playing, right? That doesn't mean I'm not role-playing. Oh, I forgot to make a stop at Blueberry. Oh, whatever. On Monday, I'm actually gonna head down to the DMV to, like, check out what's happening with my license, driving license. I kinda let it go, so I need to pick up on that again and see if I can get my driving license going. Because I have a student license, I don't really have a driving license full, you know? I can drive if I have someone else who has a full license and has been driving for 3 years next to me, but I can't drive alone or with someone else. This is where you come to get your meat. Oh, looks like someone is here. That's interesting. He's using the cheaper one. This one costs, like the one I'm using is actually kind of overpriced, I would say. But anyway. Right, so shut the engine. You gotta leave the trunk open. I think this is why they made it so you can open the trunk with the engine off. Alright, so you buy here, cargo buy. And then you put it in the trunk. Cargo store. Cargo place? Yeah. List. Vehicle cargo. Which vehicle cargo is this? Is this this one? Okay. So this one is locked, so that's fine. That guy is AFK. He could get robbed while AFK. Oh, no, he's back. Okay. Buy. Place. Buy. You can place as long... I don't know, this is a little bit, you know, spammy, I would say. Any script that would allow you to... I get why they did this. It's so that more people, like, do this, you know, and in the background you have... Okay, sell. After you don't have enough space. So it looks like you can only store, like, 10 in this one. There's a whole guide on the forum. Yeah, there's 10 here. You can store like 40 with like a bigger truck. I should have bought a bigger truck. Why am I messing with small truck? Anyway. I got the worst of both worlds. A burrito, first I wanted to get like a truck that could carry a lot. But then I thought, you know what, I wanted something faster, like a burrito. And then I decided, you know what, he wouldn't have something like a burrito. So I decided to go with a plain pony. So that's probably the worst vehicle you could get for this job. Again, it's not that... It's not the point, though. Anyway. Truck PDA. Yeah, trucker PDA. Accepting cargo. We're looking for meal. That's really good. Okay, looks like we can go here first, and then we're gonna go to the other ones to sell the rest of them. So yeah, you can go to specific businesses that are accepting cargo, which is really cool. It kinda shows you how dynamic, like, the whole system is. I really think this is cool. I really do. This is way better than LSRP's trucking system, right? I know that in real life you accept contracts and do shit like that, but you don't even know what contract you're accepting in LSRP, so don't argue that with me, okay? You don't know what contracts you're accepting. So that doesn't work. That argument doesn't work with it. Here, you know exactly what you're doing. You're buying and selling products. You're buying from one and selling to the other. I know in real life you don't do that. In real life you just have a fucking contract to deliver something and they pay you a shit ton of money for it. But here it's more realistic and more people do it because it's actually more profitable. Actually more profitable. Okay? And this is like, in LSRP, no one goes out to San Fierro, no one goes out to Las Venturas or Los Santos unless they're evading from cops or unless they're trucking and their mission is there. So, just, in here, people actually go out to Fort Carson. People actually do that shit. People actually go out of their way to leave Los Santos sometimes. And many times, I've had many times where I was stranded and I had got a pickup from a truck driver. Now, think about that. How immersive is that? Anyway, open toll. Anyway, I just really like this game. I just really liked how immersive LSRP is. A bunch of people argue LSRP is better. It's like, which server is better, that's up to you. What are you looking for? I think for starting role-playing and for smaller community and for less challenge, LSRP is definitely better. Here, there's a lot of challenge. There's a lot of, like, bullshit you're gonna... Like, not bullshit, actually. Not bullshit. All fair and square challenge. All fair and square. You gotta prove your worth, you gotta prove everything, and, you know, you gotta stand something for yourself, kinda like in real life. But there's no bullshit, like, briefcase, a magic briefcase, where you can just pull out a gun at any time. Like, what the fuck is that bullshit, LSRP? You should get rid of that. It's so bullshit. That's bullshit because it's out of character, it's out of character issue. It becomes out of character, and that removes you from immersion, it removes you from roleplay. Anyway, we're about to deliver one crate for 400 when we bought it, like, for 190. So we're gonna make 200 profit from this one crate. There you go. You just gotta make sure, you know... They should have, like, an industrial entrance in the back. No one delivers stuff like this through the front door. Trunk. Okay, we're gonna have to unlock it. And when it's unlocked and... running, you know, that's dangerous. Cargo list, boom. Cargo sell. There you go. Now no more crates. They don't want any more crates. So yeah, yeah. See, this is really cool. This is a really dynamic system, and I really like how they did this. Hold on, let's see, where's that other guy? Okay, East Los Santos, looks like they're taking 3 crates, and they are gonna give me slightly less profit, but still a lot of profit. It's better than the ship. You gotta make sure, before you sell your crates to a private business, you gotta make sure they have the price higher than the ship, because the ship will always accept however many cargo you wanna sell. There is a limit, but it's really high, so... You will always be able to buy it. You will always, and it restocks every 40 minutes, so it's fine. You just be able to always sell it there, to the ship. The ship is in port, and you can check the prices if you go to TPDA ship information. There you go, and it will let you know where exactly can you sell your shit, unless the ship is away for like 5 minutes. So it stays at the port for 40 minutes, and then it goes away for 5 minutes, and then it comes back to simulate like another ship coming in. But you can totally go on top of that ship if you're trying to roleplay. I've seen like a cool video of people roleplaying immigrants. They got on a ship and then they started recording as it was sailing, and when it like docked in, they like kinda rushed in. So that's really interesting. But yeah, there's a lot of bullshit going on LSRP as well. I mean, it happens when you are trying to basically give publicity to a server like this one. Everyone wants to be public, everyone wants to have popularity and stuff like that. But I'm fine with fans, I'm fine with fans who are like, oh man, hi, hey, what's up man, I'm cool with that. Hey, I love your videos. Hey man, thank you man, I put a lot of effort in my videos, I try to at least. Thank you so much, like that kind of people, I can appreciate them a lot. The people who just gonna go, just kind of, you know, meta game a little bit to think and think that I'm not gonna report them. Just kind of, you know, bullshit like that. People literally shout in character-wise, hey, user one, hello! Now, like I said, of course it's a game, I shouldn't take everything seriously, but I'm trying to immerse myself in roleplay. And that's when the game becomes really, really fun, you know? Oh wait, two more? Hold on. I'm gonna try to sell one more. I wanna see if that's it. No, I wanna cargo sell, that's it. No, yeah, it's full. Alright. So, basically, what I was saying is... Wait, I can store cargo while it's locked? That's weird. Alright. Basically, what I was saying is, some people just like to meta game and they think it's funny. It's not, really. You can, like, PM me, please. Don't ruin, like, the worst thing about it is that I don't even care at this point about people metagaming my name or just trolling me. Like, you saw back at the mall, I didn't give a shit about that guy. I commented on him, that's it. But, the people that I hate are the ones that slash B, like, ooh, user one is the best, or slash me, avoids user one, or some other bullshit that's completely fucking out of character. People that approach me in-game and go, hey, did you know there's a Russian live streamer? Are you fucking dumb? Literally, are you fucking dumb? That's a dumb question. You are. Seriously, like, there's no fucking excuse for that. Anyway, TPDA, let's go. That's a really shitty note. I'm sorry. I shouldn't give them all this attention. That's what they want, essentially. They just want attention. Oh, wait, I'm navigating to Binko. I don't want that. Hold on, I saw that they were accepting a meal for $4.50. Yeah, they are. Marina Burger shot. Fuck yeah. Look at this profit. I'm gonna make tons of profit from that one sale. Right. I once got ticketed for speeding on LSRP. The speed limit is really ridiculous. Look at this asshole. Not the rules don't apply to him because he has a cheetah. Now, when I call people assholes, I usually refer to them in character, from out of character perspective. But I should stop doing that, because people just take it out of character. And I'm sorry, I don't mean to insult people, unless they deserve it, I guess. Does anyone deserve getting insulted? Of course! Yeah! Yeah! Definitely! I'm Russian, and I think some people deserve getting insulted. Definitely. If people treat me like they're... Like, if people treat me... Like an asshole that I am. like, they call me all these awful names and shit. Why can't I call people awful names and shit? But usually, you know, I don't try to do it to people that don't deserve it. I don't think people deserve to be hurt, though. Like, real people. I don't think it should come to that. I don't think anyone deserves to be hurt. You know, that's the ideology that I'm really against. You know, there's always a way to solve things without violence, but I still think, you know, I still think that if people carry a gun to protect themselves and their family, I think they're justified in certain situations, especially like in America, where everyone carries a gun. If you outlaw guns in America, what's gonna happen is people who are not criminals are not gonna carry guns, but who are criminals, they're not gonna follow the law anyway, so what the fuck, right? I fucking watched some gun debates and they're fucking hilarious. You realize that a gun, the criminals don't follow the law. No, they are gonna follow the law. I fucking love these fucking debates. They're like kindergarten children. They're fucking amazing. Right. Cargo list. Let's grab a cargo. This is probably the worst place to park. But why can't I, like, deliver it from here? I think that would be the reasonable place. In single player, that was the fucking workman entrance. Why am I supposed to go through the main entrance? Right. Cargo cell. I think they only wanted just one anyway, so... Yeah, so, yeah, that's... I'm making a bit of money here. Let's calculate. Let's actually calculate how much I made. So... I invested... 190 to 10. So, 190 to 10, that's... this much money. This is how much I invested, right? Cool. So far I sold 370 times 3, that's, oh, that's complicated, 7 by 3, that's 21, plus 90, that's this amount, I think that's this amount. Then we also have 450 and 400, that's cool. That's 960, yeah. Okay, so that's how much we made so far, and that's minus this, no, is it? Yeah, that's minus this so far. But we still have crates though. How many crates do we have? Cargo list. 5 crates, so we only sold 5 crates. So that's half of this. So that's half of this. That means this is, I think this. Is it? Yeah, I think this is it. Yeah, I think this is it. So far, in theory, we made profit of $1,000. All of that work for $1,000. Are you too happy, guys? Oh my god, that's so great. Okay. Cool. We're gonna have less profit from now on, though. Because we still need to sell this. We'll probably sell this to a ship. Profit from the ship, I believe, is 360. Let me just check real quick the prices on the ship. Why am I typing MDC? Ship information, I think that was it, yeah. Meal, yeah, 360. So you, 190 to 360, that's 170, I think. Yeah, that's 170. So, each time you make 170 profit, for 5, that's 70 to 5, that's 350, plus 7, that's... Okay, so you're gonna make this much profit. So, in total, we're gonna make this much money. 2050, there you go, that's it. So much worth it, so worth it, yeah, totally. Anyway, we're gonna make our way. I probably messed up somewhere in those calculations. Leave me a comment down in the description. I'm gonna show you how to sell the products to the ship. And that's it. That's basically it. And I'll be surprised, like, there was a big conflict, big issue with people just robbing you at the ship. I'm not taking the most... Hold on, I'm taking the wrong route. I'm taking the illegal route. Which you're supposed to take is you're supposed to get on that highway. So, yeah, you're supposed to get on that highway and it'll take you straight around the airport, and around the airport there'll be the docks and you'll be able to get on that. I think, okay, people, if you're my fans, go, like, you know, start driving properly. Unless, like, obviously you're not gonna be driving properly if, say, you're role-playing drunk, right? That would be interesting. Try role-playing drunk. If you have a criminal character and you don't know what to do, drive drunk. Or do something, but have everything you do have a reason, you know? So you drove drunk because of a tragedy. Say your homie died, so you got drunk and you started driving because you have no idea of what, like, how to conduct yourself or something. Which is fine. That would be actually good roleplay. But, like, roleplay all the losses of a drunk driver. Don't actually, like, start, you know, driving super well if you're drunk, you know? Just, you know, stuff like that. Stuff like that will make for a really nice aesthetic. I love, like, whenever a person roleplays properly, this lets everyone around them be immersed in, like, this world. They realize that this person is not out there to make money, to generate assets, okay? He's not out there for that. He's out there for roleplay. And now I'm gonna address the LSRP community, the administrators. Make weapons... I really hate to say this, but, like, make weapons more accessible, because, like, it's fucking ridiculous at this point. Like, everyone, whenever I have a weapon, everyone just, they J-bug, they break rules on purpose, or make violations, or make, like, J-bugging into vehicles be a bannable offense or something, because... It's fucking ridiculous role-playing with weapons. Everyone is always like, here's a weapon! You know? And because I have recorded myself with a gun license, everyone now knows via the magic of bullshit that I have a weapon. And everyone always tries to rob me. It's fucking ridiculous. I'm not even exaggerating. Literally everyone He's always trying to. Oh fuck, we missed the fucking. No, stop! God damn it! Stop! Mission impossible! Hold on, hold on. Oh my god, I made it! why did I do that? No, wait for me! Fuck, okay. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. And, yeah, I don't know why I did that. Just kinda gone full retard. look at this. This Snickers ENV actually helped me render long distance objects. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. So come up with something interesting. Come up with something fun to do. You know, don't just be idiot like me. And stay awesome. Everybody look like ants. Way up there. You and I.